हेलो एवरीवन, मैं हूं सप्पे भाई आकाश तिवारी एंड वेलकम टू क्रिएटिवली क्रेजी कॉन्वर्सेशंस. टुडे वी हैव मिस्टर राजीव चिलाका. आई एम ट्राइंग हिम फ्रॉम लास्ट सिक्स मंथ्स टू गेट हिम ऑन अ पॉडकास्ट. ही इज द फाउंडर ऑफ ग्रीन गोल्ड एनिमेशन. यू माइट बी नोइंग छोटा भीम, इंडियाज नंबर वन कार्टून. ही इज द क्रिएटर ऑफ छोटा भीम, माइटी राजू, कृष्णा, विक्रम बेताल, चोर पुलिस, लव कोश एंड सो एंड सो ऑन. लाइक इंडिया सबसे पहला जो मतलब लीडिंग कार्टून वाले जितने भी रिलेटेड चीज है, दैट्स ग्रीन गोल्ड एनिमेशंस. थैंक यू सो मच सर फॉर कमिंग. आई जस्ट डायरेक्टली वांट टू स्टार्ट विद वन थिंग. आई नो हाउ सक्सेसफुल छोटा भीम इज, ओके, द होल फ्रेंचाइज. आई नो हाउ सक्सेसफुल ग्रीन गोल्ड इज गोइंग एंड हाउ यू गाइस आर एक्सपैंडिंग. बट व्हाट आई वांट टू आस्क यू, द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, पोकेमॉन, ड्रैगन बॉल जी, बेब्लेड, पावरपफ गर्ल्स या ऐसे कुछ कार्टून्स इंडिया में क्यों नहीं है?
ओके, सो Akash, first of all, thank you for having me, and it's good to connect with you after, I'm sorry it took 6 months, but I like your perseverance, and as you know, 3 months usme to lockdown hi tha.
Exactly.
So I was catching up on personal stuff. I'm glad we are talking, and I'm happy that overall in India, we have come a long way, that now today we have a whole generation of viewers who are watching cartoons, yeah, animation, and yeah. Today, 20-year-old or 25-year-old, nobody feels shy to watch animated shows at a movie theater or this thing. But believe me, 20 years ago, it was a whole new world. In the sense, the only people watching cartoons were somebody who was 7 or 5 or 10, but nobody above the age of 18, because they didn't feel comfortable watching those kind of things.
Yeah.
So, in terms of your question, why वैसे शो नहीं है जैसे कि Pokemon or Doraemon and all?
Yeah.
See, animation is always an evolution, in the sense, you know, everything evolves, like the storytelling evolves, the characters evolve, the designs evolve, and plot lines evolve, and finally you come to an area where you get there when you know that jo bhi aaj tak bana sakte for the market is done. So yeah. When we started, the market need tha ki ek simple, we needed somebody to tell the story of our mythology a bit. Then a little bit away, something between a mythology and a realistic show, which was Bheem. I mean, it's not a mythology, same time it's not.
Yeah, I've read the story about Bheem, yes.
So, aisa hume, we have to do that. And it is, I mean, see, the story, Japanese have been at this for 60, 70 years in terms of storytelling. India is relatively only 20 years old. You know, a lot of people, abhi tak jo bhi, people who have come into this field or recently are the people who are artists who can draw, or they don't have any other job, they're coming into this field. But there are very few people who have, like 10% only of the people who have come with because they love this field. They've come to this as an option, kya aur kuch kar le. But when we see this passionate people coming, you know, the newer generation, that is probably your generation or younger generation, these are the ones who can create the next level of shows. We are basically creating the path and, you know, that kind of a thing. Like just what happened in the US and Disney and all. Start with what Disney's early stories were all folk tales or something inspired from Irish or English or whatever kind of fairy tales. From there, today you don't see anything like that happening at that level.
Mm.
So India is evolving. Indian storytelling has come a long way. So we will see definitely amazing shows coming out of India too. And I mean, anime is again a genre of the style of animation that the Japanese specialize. And that is where I think we need to find our own way of doing things than we want to be some style.
Yes, I agree. I'm not saying that Bheem isn't the right one. It's the perfect one. And you guys have nailed it in that thing. What I mean to say is, jaisa aapne bola na ki Disney also started with folk tales and stuff. You guys started, and the newer people needs to do this. So you are the leading team and you are the leading business in cartoons and all. So don't you think, because dekho, jaisa I am 21, I still watch Pokemon, I still watch Dragon Ball Z, I still watch those cartoons because I could, I'm still a big fan of it. And mere age ke log bahut log dekhte hain till now. They even watch on torrents, cartoons, Netflix, whatever it is. So what I mean to say is ki only you guys can create it right now, aur kiske paas ek power nahi hai. Aap logo ke paas power hai, because Indian mythology pe jo Ramayan tha, lot of people have tried to make Ramayan, but the Japanese people who made Indian Ramayan mythology, you know, the legend of Ramayan is bahut famous nikla tha. People still watch these cartoons. So that's what I was asking ki yaar India mein se aise kyun nahi hai aise log, like why are people not making it? Everyone is complaining. People like me, mere aise bahut log bolte honge. But ban kyun nahi raha? That's what I wanted to know.
Yeah, I think I like what you said. I think you suggested that hum log kar sakte hain. So we will work on it and we will do it. But like I said, it is a process of evolution of artists to us to writers and everything. All as you see, jo product India mein bani hai 2003-4-5 mein aur last 3-4 years mein. And I'll give an example of a spin-off series from Bheem, which is Mighty Little Bheem.
Mighty Little Bheem.
Now it is the first time that an Indian product has gone global.
Yes.
Because if you see Mighty Little Bheem on Netflix, you will find that now the quality of the content can compete with DreamWorks. You know, the storytelling can compete with Pixar. You know, maybe not. But that's what I think. I would like to think. But maybe not. We are not there yet. But the fact of the reason is that in 2019 on Netflix, this was there 27 million households across the globe who have watched this content. So yes, Bheem cannot be the anime that you guys want to be, but our next show can be, and we will definitely try. And you know, the, like you said, you know, I would love. In fact, you know, I'll tell you honestly, there are 7 or 8 shows that I have personally written, which the audience of 11 to 16, that means to young adults also, but there is no buyer in India. In the sense, hum log wahi bana sakte jo log khareed rahe hain. I'm trying to pitch my show. There are some, all of these, a few of them are girl-based show. I mean, people don't want it. There is a few shows that are for the 11 to 16, much more sexier than most shows that are out there today in the sense of this thing. But again, they don't want it because people want a tried and tested version. Yeh chalega, yeh de do. Vada pav hi chahiye. So it is not just me or few studios out there.
Yeah.
Like I said, ecosystem needs to evolve. And it's just a matter of time. You know, it'll take its own time. But in the meantime, the other networks, like other OTT platforms, we are more experimental now. We can do more experiments with the advent of OTT platforms for the domestic market. So it's just a matter of time. You will see much more content that will, you know, that will stay longer. And hopefully the babies who are being born now will watch that content till they're 20.
Yeah, more than their 20. I hope so. 20 ke upar bhi dekho. I still love cartoons. But yeah, I know how difficult it is because aapka story mujhe pata hai ki Chhota Bheem was actually, the ideation was in 2003-2004, but usko aate 7-8 ho gaya. People didn't want it Chhota Bheem tabhi. So I know how difficult it is, and then aapka patience, like the office, naya office aana, fir wo bhi fire ka problem, and then again. So itna patience hone ke baad still you're creating more and more shows, so nice one. And I actually saw Mighty Little Bheem on Netflix. What I wanted to ask you is ki, so I don't know how Netflix is managing their kids ka zone. So do you think ki Mighty Little Bheem is gonna able to compete with those content? Because TV se hatke directly wo log YouTube pe aate, not Netflix. I don't know if people are going on Netflix ke kids ke zone pe.
In India, the number of viewers on Netflix is very, very bare minimal. I think it's about, what I know is probably 500,000 viewers only. So in India, it has not become a habit yet, Netflix. But whereas in US, basically 1/3 of the US population has Netflix, they are subscribers of Netflix.
Yeah.
And other countries in Latin America, Europe and all, they subscribe to Netflix a lot. So so in those countries, the viewing habits are different. Hence, out of the 27 million households that who have seen Mighty Little Bheem last year, hardly 20,000 households are there in India. The rest of the viewing is coming from other parts of the world, which I am very proud of, because nice. Like you said, why we can't make, we are in the process, but it is a process. And like Mighty Little Bheem is a preschool show, it targets preschoolers. And preschoolers, pretty innocent and stuff, they don't care bacha Indian hai, Chinese hai, or black hai, or white hai, they don't care. They are the only people in the world, they don't have any boundaries set. You know, they judge things as per the story. They laugh, they are the most, the purest of, that's why they say bacche bhagwan ke roop hote, especially the little ones who are less than 5. So I think that is the target. And yes, in India, Netflix is not yet as popular. They will take time. But the good news is that maybe later this year or next year, Mighty Little Bheem will be on one of the TV stations in India and across the world. So there we will have access to more. And also, if you search for Mighty Little Bheem, it's on YouTube also. For those kids who watch it, it is there. And believe me, there are 500 million views of Mighty Little Bheem alone on YouTube. That was some data I have from 6 months ago. So it is kind of, if you go to Netflix Junior's channel and see on YouTube and see which is the topmost videos, it's all Mighty Little Bheem. It is not your Japanese cartoons. It is not your whatever you were talking about. Any of the show, find me there. Then I will give you an award for that. But yeah, as Indians, we have to work our way up the ladder. Yeah. It is not straight or forward. Like, it's easy to say something. But it's a process. I mean, like you saw Indian cricket team earlier in the 80s and 90s, they wouldn't dive because they played on the streets or in grounds where there was no grass. But today's cricketers, they dive they fly in the air. The Indian same guys, right? Because the interest there that, you know, they played on grass. I mean, they're fielding on that and they're used to it. So the whole ecosystem, that's why in one of the best teams in the world. Similarly, animation also is the same thing. It is an evolving process and it's just a matter of that time that we will be one of the leading producers in the world. We will have movies that will come out of Indian box office that will do $1 billion at the global box office. Just a matter of time.
This is a very important question. Kaisa hai ki, you are a CEO, okay? You're a businessman, you're a founder of a company. At the same time, you're a creative person. You created so many shows and stuff. Okay? So when numbers come, then creative is very difficult. Hota hai. दिमाग खराब कर देता है ठीक है सो हाउ डू यू मैनेज टू बी बोथ एट द सेम टाइम बिकॉज जब नंबर्स आ जाते हैं सब ये बिजनेस 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 होता था इट हैम्पर्स योर क्रिएटिव साइड एंड यू आर ट्राइंग टू डू बोथ
ब्रिलियंट क्वेश्चन आई कंप्लीटली अग्री टू व्हाट यू सेड इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू मैनेज वेयर टू हैट्स इन द सेंस ट्राई टू बी क्रिएटिव ट्राई टू बी बिजनेस यू नो इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू बी दैट वन पर्सन हु कैन डू बोथ आई थिंक luckily for us for managing the creativity aspects of our, we have a large team. Similarly, business wise also we have a large team, but over the last 7-8 years, especially once Bheem became a hit and other shows we launched, for 4-5 years out of those 7-8 years, I lost my way. I couldn't be creative, neither I could be amazing business or no. I could do neither properly. So I made a lot of mistakes in this time. You know, we have done shows that I'm not very happy about, or they didn't work, or I was not dedicated enough to do something which, you know, you make these mistakes and you keep them. Again, they repeat after a while. So it is not like you rightly said. And last 2-3 years, I've been trying very hard to focus on the creative aspects of the thing. And that's when we are able to create Mighty Little Bheem. Me and my team, we sat together. I spent a lot of time for that. But again, there is only so much time I can spend on it. Again, credit goes to the team at Green Gold. They've done an amazing job, especially with Mighty Little Bheem. But yes, this is an ongoing process. And trust me, the lockdown just changed me completely. In the sense, I could reconnect with my old self, you know, take my own time to do things. And I have written about 3 shows during the thing, including a couple of movies in this time. Not written in the sense, not the whole thing.
Ideation.
And, you know, synopsis level. I've written a show which got approved in a regional OTT platform, which has got a hybrid, basically a live action and animated this thing. Then I have written a movie story, which one of very big writers is developing it further. 2 movie stories, and then I've written 2 more shows, and overall, like, there were 10 ideas that I've explored. I think I'm glad that I had this break to reevaluate myself. So I, in fact, thought I'll retire after this during the lockdown. I told my wife and my kids that I'm done. I'm happy. I'm so happy at home. I want to retire. And they freaked out, obviously. They said, "Dad, you have 3 kids," my son said. "Yeah, why will you take care of us?" And also, then I said, "That's a point." And then what I did was, so that was a phase I went through.
Yeah.
Then I said, you know, I need to focus on the creative aspects. So the moment I started coming to work, now I started delegating things better, trusting people to do their job, then getting into every single aspect, which was my bad habit earlier. And I learned from that. And this lockdown period helped me come to terms with that.
And exactly, it's actually not possible to handle both. But even you are learning at this age, ki creative side pe work karke. So are you still struggling to manage business and creative together?
How it is, it's basically using your right brain and left brain, as you know. If you try to, example, you're working on an idea or story, you want a completely different environment. In the sense, you can't be in the hustle bustle. You have to be in a quiet place. You have to be at peace. Everything at, you know, if you have to be at peace, then you are able to do something good about it.
Hmm.
So when it is business related, you have to be active. Your blood should be, you know, you should be high energy levels. You have to be not sitting at one place, but you're moving around to get ideas and getting things done. So I choose different days to do different things. So I'm trying to do this, try to set a timetable where I don't have to, I can really focus on few things at a time. And most important thing is, like, with this lockdown, again, it has really benefited me personally. Business-wise, ups and downs will always be there. I'm not really, I never make money or anything. I just love what I am doing. So I will find a way to survive. So will my company. But yeah, I think now we're thinking, last Wednesday meeting with my teammates where, hey, what is the content we're going to make next 5 years? Earlier, we used to think next 5 months, what are we going to do? Now I'm thinking next 5 years, let us make a plan. We wrote down the points. Tomorrow we have follow-up meeting. So every Wednesday we're going to have a creative meeting. We're going to go back and do things that we want to do great things. In the sense, obviously nothing will happen overnight. But now we realize the focus of creative stuff is going to be more. As you notice, whatever you said, all these were done in 2008, 9, 10, 11, 12. Between 12 and 16, 17, 18, we had nothing. 19, again, we had Kalari Kids and Mighty Little Beam and Kung Fu Dhamaka, a little different things, but we still had something different come out, 2019. So last 6 years, 5 years, I've been just messing up and making all mistakes I could, but I'm glad that phase is over. I hopefully won't make those mistakes again.
So coming to collaborations and brand, you guys have more than 100 collaboration merchandises and stuff, and you are earning. So, how did you set this up and how are you earning right now? Because people think that you guys are earning just through shows. Ki show dala, banaya, TV pe dekha, ya bas that's it. Aisa nahi hai.
See, generally, most of the business earnings come through the production. When we produce the show, that's where the income to the company comes, because that's a chunk of cost. After that is usually royalties or renewal fees and, you know, license fees. For example, we charge a license fee to a brand. We use Chota Bheem to put it on the product, their product. So let's say Parle G, Bheem is on top of the pack. They will, or Savlon, where you see those hand wash things, you may have seen more.
Yeah, I've seen the Bheem ka photo and all stuff. Right?
They pay us a license fee. Yeah, I mean, it is not like that we are making a lot of money, but it just keeps us going. And like that, a lot of these small things put together, it's a decent money. And then, of course, we have opportunity to make some income from YouTube. We used to make that earlier. Now it has gone down.
Yeah.
And then we opportunities to license the content we own to OTT platforms such as Amazon or Netflix or Hotstar or whatever. Whoever is interested in keeping our show, you have an opportunity to do that. And also, you have opportunities to sell your content outside of India. And usually, the content so far we made has been predominantly limited to Indian subcontinent or a few countries, Southeast Asian countries such as Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand, Indonesia. These countries, it has done reasonably well. But most of the content what we've done did not work anywhere else. But I think Mighty Little Beam is a different story. We will have a lot more opportunities to do across the world a deal, and we can do a lot more with that. So let's see. So generally, typically, most of our income still comes from TV production, but other income also comes to us.
But right now, there's a lot of controversy chal rahi regarding Chutki ki Shaadi and the memes getting on Twitter and stuff. Then I saw your statement. But what's going on? Like, how did you guys give any hint or how did it start?
Yeah, so a lot of people started, some journalists called me, bola suna hai chutki aur Bheem ki shaadi ho rahi. Maine bola sorry, maine aapko bulaya nahi. In a sense, see, anybody and everybody who's reading the news, they know it's fake news. You know, everybody knows that. But it's something that we always thought about, you know. Okay, people have thought about it. So somebody, a smart person, whoever has put it out there, thought about it, they knew enough about Bheem that what if Bheem marries Indumati instead of Chutki, and they just put it out. But, you know, honestly, in Dolakpur, they're all kids and we never go beyond trying to make any rishta anywhere, you know, just like kids play innocently.
Yeah, obviously. You know,
that's what it, we want to be in the world of Dolakpur. But of course, friendship is different from love or anything. We don't do that anywhere. Of course, we show acts of friendship in Dolakpur and all, but never acts of like shadi and all those kind of things. But this was funny, whatever. It was funny that so many people started talking about it.
Exactly. Chutki ki shadi is trending and justice for Chutki. It's trending on Twitter.
So they trend. What was trending was Bheem and Indumati.
Bheem ki shadi and it was like justice for Chutki. These two hashtags were trending.
Yeah, I mean, everybody knows it's fake. Everyone knows all those things, but it was interesting. Interesting stuff to happen. Overall, I think I wish our movies got this kind of attraction and people notice our movies more than this controversy. So,
but exactly. It was very interesting. What I did is, I had this on my story, views about Indian cartoons. Okay. And like people just went crazy. There were a lot of responses. I'm not going to show all the responses, but I have few responses. You don't need to give explanation to each and everyone, but whatever you want to respond or react in short. So they are saying ki they hardly show the reality of Indians. They only show the village scenes or India, how used to be in ages ago.
Dolakpur is generally set in a fictional time. We don't say it's 20 or we don't say it is 14th century. We're not showing the India of 2020. We're showing basically a timeless place where it happened. That's why there is a king. A lot of we're able to do a lot of things.
Lacks content, graphics, and character development, story, creativity, humor.
I mean, of course, there would be definitely everything that has ever been created can be better, including Bheem, Chota Bheem. And in case we get an opportunity to recreate Chota Bheem, tell thing, we'll do it in a whole new, different way. And of course, with whatever, obviously, if the show, if everything is bad, nobody. Not many people will be watching today and still working, still runs. That means we got something right there and hopefully we'll go on. This brand new series of Bheem also coming. Hopefully that's better than the earlier ones.
See, that's the response of the people. Because I know you do researches about kids' habits, food, everything. I know how you guys function. I have seen Mighty Little Bheem. I like the graphics and stuff, but these are the responses and lacks visualization and compelling stories. But in the end, when I said ki how many Indian cartoons you remembered, everyone said Chota Bheem. So the recall value is 101%.
Yeah, see, we honestly try to keep the stories simple. We are not trying to impress, like I said, it's not meant for a 16-year-old's brain. Whoever can read and write and type and all these things, obviously, the same people have enjoyed the show when they were 6 or 7. It is meant for innocent child's mind, and it is basically meant for, it's supposed to keep it simple and everything. Unlike what you mentioned about, it's not a complicated storyline. We have kept it simple generally, and hopefully we'll be able to keep it simple. That's the reason it works, especially for kids. Keep it simple, it'll work.
Coming to the present and the futuristic things, if people want to come in animation, in cartoons, if they need to come and they need to take it to another level, so what do you require from new, younger people? What are the skills they should be having, or what are the things they should be having when, if they want to enter this or if they should be entering it?
So luckily, the field of animation, visual effects, gaming, they're all interlinked and it's pretty vast. And it is no longer that, you know, drawing only you can enter this field. You are only creative, then you can enter this field. It is not true. Basically, you need to love this field. You know, you need to love animation. That's the first criteria. Or gaming or VFX, whatever. You need to be liking something, and something had to be motivating you to do that. Maybe you have the skill, maybe you don't, but you can certainly learn the skill of learning the software, to a lot of things. And maybe creativity is there inside that person. Unless you explore, you wouldn't know you're creative or not. Example, unless you write a story, you don't know you are a good storyteller or a bad storyteller. So I would say that, you know, there is no one way that you, there is no particular skill is necessary. One, you need to know you love it or not. If you don't love it, you should stay away from it and do what you love. But if you love it, explore what you're good with. Know your strengths. Like, are you good with colors or character design or animation or VFX, you know, using... Are you good at softwares? Are you good at creating games or wacky ideas? Put it down. You need to explore your strengths. And once you know what is your strength, then work on it. Look for a job in that place or build your own company around it or whatever. But still, in India, there is a lot of content needed in this space. A lot of creators are needed. Honestly, I feel that most best ideas probably come from people who are between age of 16 and 22, but they generally tend to make fun of their ideas themselves. But I would recommend that please believe in your ideas. What you may be thinking may be awesome. Just write a story, believe in yourself. You'll find a way to produce it or make it or make it happen. You'll definitely gonna just try it. Be it a game, again, there is a lot of new things happening. Emerging media, AR, VR. Sky's the limit. And we do have a lot of competition. I mean, like, obviously, a few years later, a lot of these things will be built, hopefully, in India, with what is happening in China and all. There's a lot of talks going on. But I think we need to make India self-sufficient, you know, make in India content. Yes, we can certainly compete there. But I don't know the other parts. But I hope we will be able and, you know, I'd like to see India on top.
Everyone, but have you ever tried collaborating with some other people like content creators or maybe people like us, our age, into this? The animation, the cartoon thing would be going to another level.
We have writers in the office who are 19 years old, two who is 45 years old. So
talking about yourself.
So we have different age groups. Same way, we are also exploring ideas and stuff. We are collaborating with other studios who have done some outstanding work themselves. We have tried a few other IPs and stuff, which we tried to take it to the market. People didn't take it or sale didn't happen. Like us, generally, usually 3 to 4 years is usually what time from start you pitch the ideas. Your market timing, everything has to be right. So we definitely are looking to collaborate with more young people, more creators, like I mentioned. More, in fact, girl directors, because I think they are the one who have more heart and compassion than the boy directors, especially in animation. So we've been looking a few, but not many, not enough. This thing who understands, we all have little experience, especially to tell girl stories. You know, it's not easy. I mean, very hard for a guy to tell a girl story. You know, we've been looking for those kind of talent, and we are yet to come across. I said this in many forums and all, wherever I spoke and told them, we need to find this new generation of writers, creators, directors who believe in self, who write and understand kids, more importantly.
So if you're looking for creators, I'm open for office, but I just want to say, tell me your shittiest moment in your entire career. Like, it can be people not accepting Chota Bheem from 2003 to 2007. It can be anything, but what was that one shittiest moment in your entire career which you thought, ki matlab, kya, kyu, kya, kuch bhi nahi samajh aaya?
Including, you know, when you get trolled, you know, or some people write shit about the show, you feel like, okay, what business you got and all, but of course, everybody is entitled to their own opinion. And we live in a free world. I mean, like, when we get criticized of doing something and we feel a little, you know, taken aback. There are shitty moments. Sometimes, suddenly in a presentation, some parent will jump in and say, oh, Bheem is a violent show. Why did you create that? They get aggressive. So, like, what? Okay. So these kind of things are a little funny. But in general, overall, I think we realize that we do have a responsibility towards the next generation of kids. So we need to handle it carefully. We want to treat it right and all. And shitty moments wise, you know, there are many. You just said countless ones. From, you know, if that suddenly there's no money, like payments come late, they promise you dates, they don't come. We have to pay salaries. Animators are like, obviously their morale is down if they don't get paid on time. Especially in the early years of the company, that was really hard to deal with people and all, because they wouldn't simply listen to you if you don't pay them on time. And everybody needs to survive, so totally understand their feeling also. So there have been plenty, you know, plenty of people telling me on my face, this company will go nowhere. Not now, in the early years. There are plenty of bigger companies making fun of me back then, earlier days. So I took it all in my stride. And a lot of insults, even today also, come from international companies. When I'm telling my ideas or my goal, they laugh at me. I said, don't worry, I'll make it happen, show it to you. That's what I tell them.
Ooh, shit, there's so much of... It's difficult. Shows which are related to 16P and all are expected to come. We need buyers for that. We need people who need to change their thinking about animation and stuff. And we need people who support our Indian cartoons and animation. What do you want from the normal audience, people like us?
See, honestly, as an audience, you would like to watch. If you go to a theater, you want to watch, obviously, the best of the movie. I mean, there is 4 movies, you'll choose the best one. And if you go, for example, an animated movie is there, an Indian animated movie, whoever made it doesn't matter. But if you go to that movie and the movie is not so good, obviously you feel disappointed and no one else goes after that. But I think there is a huge challenge for the people who made it or whatever and getting there. And some kind of a support or something to try, people go to the theaters to watch Indian animated films. That will be a great help from, you know, regular people. Then you know that, oh, okay, let us say that I spent 100 rupees on producing the film. If I'm getting even 100 rupees back, I'm encouraged to produce more. But when we put, example, not me, I've been crazy enough to keep trying that at the box office. We have produced 6 movies so far, but a lot of producers who tried 1 or 2 times and they didn't get even 10% of their money back, they got, you know, they said they made a promise that they will never ever produce because the youngsters don't go watch the film, you know. But unless they watch the film, how do they know the film is good or bad? And I think we seem somewhere to disrespect our own genre of films. It used to be the same back in the days of Hindi films and regional films. You know, we should only, people would not say that they watch Hindi films. They will watch, I watch only Hollywood film. Well, sure. But end of the day, they're coming home and watching Hindi films. I mean, we just need to accept what we are. This is the country. Our shows, our thing. You like it, watch it again. If you don't like it, never come back. But we need to try that.
Because I have seen people going for Frozen, people going for... aisa nahi hai ki kids ke movie dekhte nahi hai. They always used to be Ice Age. They were always used to be Frozen. People are still going and watching it. But we
absolutely... Frozen or something, they've spent a minimum of $100 million in producing the film. Wherein we in India, even if you spend, you know, $1 million, you will not recover that money because nobody's going to the thing. So how can ever a producer make money? Even if you, let's say that I made a Frozen, I call it something else and I put it out there, no one will come to the theater because they think this is substandard is made in India. I think that thinking needs to change. And that thing, again, that's an evolution. A good film has to match with the audience will come. So that's kind of something that will go on and on and on till the time, like, you know, we can make that. Example, Bahubali. Look at the collections of Bahubali India-wide.
Man.
Original film. That show's content is king. But, I mean, Rajmouli's for earlier films like Ega and all, didn't release in theaters. But if he did, I think he would have made big money also. But whatever he makes next, imagine what kind of money those will make. So it takes time. And it is not as... He's been there at it for about 20 years himself. That's when now he got success in Bahubali. I think that's what we need to be. We need to be continuously at it till we find the way out. And it's for everyone. When good content is coming, people will watch it, obviously. But the good thing with OTTs and all, there is always that film out there. Somebody is going to watch it. Somebody misses in the theaters, you have a platform where they can get that high quality animation, same as it is. They can watch that on their own theaters or their, on their, you know, on their iPads or whatever. So that's the positive. So I think in the future, it's all about direct to consumer. That is, whatever people are creating will directly go to the consumer. So it's going to be a very exciting time for content creators. So if you're not into content, get into content as soon as you can.
Oh, yes, that's right. And I hope and I genuinely want, because that's the reason I was behind you, because main chahta hu ki Indian cartoons, Indian anime, like they just go to next level, because everyone is crazy, but not for our own thing. So that's what I really want, and I hope ki wo. And yeah, I don't want to take much of your time, because बहुत टाइम से परेशान कर रहा हूँ, बट हाउ डिड यू फील, हाउ डिड यू लाइक द पॉडकास्ट, या हम लोगों को क्या क्या करना
चाहिए? You understand, I mean, you're the best guy for me to talk to than a 7-year-old, because he may not be able to express what it is. We want to improve, and that's what we do constantly, and we hope to make better shows and better movies in the future. And we, as a, whenever you know, the new generation, I hope they will be watching our shows even when they're 21.
For sure. And thank you so much, Rajiv, it means a lot, and good luck to Green Gold. And I know your passion, because I have studied you. Thank you so much for doing whatever you have done for the Indian animation and cartoon scene. And good luck. Like, we are going to nail it.
Yeah, Akash, we have a long way to go. And make India proud. Take care.
Take care. Thank you so much, Rajiv.